We're Fect Perfection, and we made Bolstad the Lone Warrior. Bolstad is a top-down shooter roguelike. The player must shoot, slash, and dodge their way through procedurally generated dungeons. Along the way, they'll encounter various unique enemies, including three bosses. The enemies' behaviors are tooled to require an adaptive playstyle. Players must think on their feet. As the player clears rooms, they are rewarded with active and passive items that affect gameplay and synergize with each other in unique ways. Bolstad is designed to be hectic, challenging, and addictive.
Bolstad's combat was radically reworked after the first month of development. This turned out to be a very good decision, especially since we came to it so early, before our codebase had solidified. It also gave us plenty of time to rework and balance the new systems. Our original design was a much slower, calculated game. The player's experience also relied upon drop rates too much. This design failed to reward skillful play. Bolstad's new design is a much faster game, focusing on fast reactions rather than strategic thinking. The player also has much more control. Skillful play is consistently encouraged and rewarded. One way we achieved this was changing the sword from a temporary item to an ability the player always has at their disposal. In place of durability, the sword uses drips, which are gained by shooting enemies. Early on in the project, we set out to define our game's design fundamentals. These changed quite a bit before the end. In the first week of production, we came up with these pillars: easy to pick up, hard to master, calculated, precise, tactical combat, traversal, overcoming difficulties, risk-reward choices, and procedural generation. These pillars were far too narrow, and we had too many of them. They tended to be poorly defined and sometimes even unrelated to the core game loop. After 3 months, we began to realize many of our decisions were conflicting. They often couldn't be linked to design pillars, even if they improved the game. Many of the arguments had no solid basis, and this resulted in many harmful compromises. So, we got together and built a new set of design pillars: skillful, reactive, fluid, and aggressive. These pillars are much more concise and are able to be applied to more aspects of the game. We also spent more time explicitly defining them. These pillars provided a point of reference during arguments and unified our vision of the finished product. Another large change to the project was shifting from an open-world model to a linear one. In our initial concept, the player would be able to explore the first dungeons in whatever order they'd like, but would always unlock the hardest dungeon last. Near the end, we decided to cut this idea. This was one of the best decisions we made. Linear design fit our scope much more readily and empowered our level designers to build meaningful IPM setups. Our team had very specialized roles. One of the upsides to this are that each specialization got a lot of quality time, and each team member was able to deeply focus on and excel in their field. However, a downside was that each member was the only person able to fix problems related to their work. We mitigated this by communicating and documenting problems so each specialist could prioritize them. Another downside was a lack of crosstalk between fields when designing. For example, the enemy designs and level designs could have been more cohesive if they were designed in tandem from the beginning.
My name's Griffin DeBlay, and I was in charge of UI. One of my greatest tasks was creating a layout for the interface that was consistent across the entire game so as to make navigating menus easy and intuitive. It was also important that the player's HUD displayed all the necessary information such as armor, health, ammo, and drips, as well as other tools such as the minimap and the action bar. The importance of feedback was definitely my biggest takeaway from this project. Particle effects and shaders provided a great deal of help towards visual feedback, but setting up haptics and audio feedback is a must.
Hi, I'm Jonathan Kessler, and I was one of the level designers on the team. One takeaway I had from this project was the importance of communication. I feel that if I collaborated more with the other level designer and the AI programmer, I could have greatly improved the quality of each of my rooms and the dungeons as a whole. This is something I plan to do on any teams I work on in the future.
Hello, I'm Mitchell Page, and I'm one of the level designers for Bolstad. The main thing I took away from working on this project was that I needed to learn how to better communicate and collaborate with other members whose work could have severe influence on my own. Me and the other level designer kind of just did our own thing. There were several times where we reviewed each other's designs, but we definitely should have done more cross-examination. Also, collaborating with the AI programmer to change some of the enemy metrics could have made iteration on level design much quicker and easier.
My name is Robert Bowerly, and I was one of the lead programmers on Bolstad. One of the biggest takeaways I had was scripting practices. This was a project that had a lot of systems being used, so it was very important that the memory and CPU usage was kept in check, so I learned about good practices in those areas. One of the biggest and most interesting tasks that I worked on during this project was the procedural generation system, which allowed us to turn a small amount of room designs into renewable content for players.
I'm Colby Peck. I did systems and AI. My biggest takeaway would be the power of modular systems, especially state machines. The projectile, health, fire, and explosion systems are all modular and centralized, and the base enemy state machine holds several hundred lines of helper functions. All of this made the process of prototyping enemies very short. For example, the final boss's design is fairly complex, but he only took 8 hours to prototype.
I'm Dylan Darth Raider, and I was producer on Bolstad. By taking on the mantle of producer, you also take on a lot of responsibility. It's your job to make sure everyone has tasks and that everyone is working towards a singular vision. By being productive myself, I boosted the productivity of everyone, but that goes both ways. If I went off the radar or went through a lull, the entire project suffered. My biggest takeaway is that it's better to be less productive more consistently than to be highly productive in bursts. Don't bite off more than you can chew and always be available to your team. Overall, working on Bolstad was a very positive experience for all of us. We were dedicated to the game, and it resulted in a product we're proud of. We each learned a lot from both the teachers and each other. Some final words of advice: don't be afraid to cut content, don't be afraid to change design early on, and make good design pillars as early as possible. On behalf of Effect Perfection, thank you for watching.